This video will be helping with the introduction to your binary number system, as well as how we do the counting in your binary number system, that is for hexadecimal, for octal, as well as your binary numbers. Okay, so now let's start. So if we talk about your decimal number, you know about your decimal numbers, right? Normal number counting, you know, right? But if we talk about your binary system, the binary system also represents those numbers or those values, but in a different way. So if we talk about your binary one, the binary number has two numbers it needs, that is your 0 or 1. Okay, so that's why if you are representing a binary number, you will always represent it with the base 2. Okay, and if we talk about your hexadecimal, in the same way, hexadecimal has 16 numbers. You can see this table. I will be coming to this table afterwards. So if you talk about the hexadecimal, we have 16 numbers, so we give base 16, and for octal we give base 8, okay, because we have 8 numbers. So this is basically how you represent your binary number system in different forms. Okay, now talking about the table, so here you can see the table. Okay, here you can see the table for hexadecimal, for binary, and for octal. Okay, now to draw this table, what I did is, if you know the what is binary addition, there are certain rules for binary addition. Like if 1 plus 1 you do, then it will become your sum will become 0 and your carry will become 1, right? And in case if you do 1 plus 0 or 0 plus 1, your result will be, sum will be 1, carry will be 0. And if you do 0 plus 0, then your sum will be 0 and carry will be 0. So using this binary addition rules, I have drawn this table. Okay, so what I did is, I started with all 4 zeros. Okay, don't see here and there, just see the table itself. Okay, then what I did is, I've just added 1 to it. So you can see 1 is added, and again I have added 1 after this. So if you see here, 1 plus 1 is, sum is equals to 0, sum is equals to 0, and carry will go to the next one, so it will become 10. Okay, after that again I have added 1, so you can see 0 plus 1 will be 1. So again you can see that 1 is over here. Okay, now you can see we have to add again 1. So what we'll do is, 1 plus 1 will become 0, carry will go here, and again 1 plus 1 will become 0, carry will go here. So you can see it became 100, right? In the same way, again I have added 1, then again I have added 1, so you can see that carry will go here, then 1 will become, 1 will come over here and 1 here. Then again same thing I have done, added 1, so 0 plus 1 1, and this will be coming down like this. Okay, then again I have added 1, so you can see 1 will come over here also by carry. So like this, you'll be easily be able to draw the table like this. Okay, for 4 digit one. Okay, now talking about the hexadecimal, hexadecimal has 4 digit values. Okay, 4 digits value. So the table you are seeing is suitable for this hexadecimal. Okay, so if you want to see the equivalent binary to your hexadecimal, that is 0 in hexadecimal, you can take it as your normal number counting also. Okay, but after, from your 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, that we write A, B, C, D, E, F in hexadecimal. Okay, so that is the only difference, else it matches your general counting. Okay, so now let's see. So for representing 0, you will represent it with 4 zeros. Then for 1, you will represent it like this. For 2, you will represent it like this, and so on till last one. Okay, so this is your hexadecimal representation. Now if we see your octal decimal, octal representation, that is a bit different. Okay, so your octal is your 3 digit. Okay, remember this thing, don't get confused. Your hexadecimal is your 4 digit representation, so we have 4 numbers, but your octal is your 3 digit representation. Okay, so that's why you can see the line over here. So this is your octal. Okay, octal has only 8 numbers. Okay, that's why we use base 8. Okay, so that is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, and if you want a binary equivalent, then because it is a 3 digit representation, we will only have 3 digits over here. Okay, and we will not use this one. So if you are drawing a table for octal, then it will be like this, and for whole hexadecimal it will be like this. Okay, so for 0 it will be 3 zeros, for 1 it will be 0 0 1, for 2 it will be 0 1 0, for 3 it will be 0 1 1, for 4 as 100, for 5 as 101, and for 6 as 110, and for 7 as 111. Okay, so no problem with this. Now comes is like if you are given some number in your decimal, okay, and you need to convert these numbers into your hexa or binary or your octal. Okay, so how will we doing this? So for converting from decimal to your hexadecimal or binary or octal, what you'll be doing is you'll be taking the help of LCM method. Okay, if you don't know, I'll be giving you examples, no need to worry. And what you have to do the reverse, like if you want to do the reverse from here to here, then what you'll be doing is you'll be making use of the power method. Okay, I'll be telling you that also. So like if you want to go from your decimal to your any of this, then you'll be making use of the LCM method. And if you want to go from your hexadecimal to your or your binary to your decimal or octal to your decimal, then you'll be making use of your power system. Okay, so this is the basic idea. If we talk about that, now let's see how we will actually apply this. Okay, so let's start with the LCM part. Okay, and yeah, before coming to that also, your decimal representation is of base 10. Why? So because you have 10 numbers over there, that's why we represent it with base 10. Okay, like we represent it with base 16, base 2 and base 8. Okay, so for example, you are given a number as 12. Okay, and you have to find the equivalent binary. So I told you, right, if you want to convert anything from decimal to any of this, you need to use the LCM method, right? So what we'll do is we'll find the LCM, but the base of binary is 2, so we'll make use of 2 for finding the LCM. okay, so you can see 2, 6 are 12 and the remainder will be over here, the question will be over. Okay, 2, 3 is a 0, then 2 1s are 2, 1 remainder. Okay, and once you get a remainder as 1, you need to stop it right over. And if you want to take out your binary equivalent, then it will be like this from down to up. Okay, that is your 1 1 0 0. Okay, and now here if you still like not sure whether it is right or not, you can match the table over here. For 12, as I wrote for 12 earlier, I had wrote for 12 it is 110 double 100, then you see 1100. Okay, in the same way, if you want to find out your equivalent of your you can say, like if this number is 12 and you want to find out the, let's take a bigger number. Okay, let's take a bigger number as 22. Okay, let's take a bigger number as 22 and we need to find the equivalent hexadecimal. So what we'll do is we'll make use of the base 16. Okay, so we'll make use of base 16. So 16 ones are 16 and your remainder is your 8. Your remainder is 8, right? 16 plus, sorry, your remainder is 6. Okay, and now what you'll do is, so you got your you can say remainder as 1, and if you get a remainder below your 16, then you'll be consulting this table, you'll stop right there. Okay, so your equivalent hexadecimal is 16 base 16. Okay, now what if your remainder comes like 11, like let's imagine like your remainder came as 11, then you will be not be writing this 11 like this, then you'll be taking the value as B. So if it was 11, then you would write at B6. Okay, because it will become confusing, you can see that, right? So if value goes above 10, we make use of this alphabet. So that is the one thing, and this is LCM method, and same you can apply on octal also. Okay, like for example, same number, let's try 22 is there, and then you have to use 8 because the base is 8. Okay, so 8 ones are 8, 2 is a 16, 8 2 is a 16, right? And remainder is your 6, so your representation is 26 base 8. Okay, so you can see LCM method is very easy, right? Now let's see the other method I told you for count, for bringing or making conversion from hexadecimal, binary or octal to your decimal. Okay, so for that what we use is power system. Okay, power method or power system you can use. So what we do is, like, for example, you have a number as, let's take any number like the last one which you told, 16. Okay, so for example, 16 is a hexadecimal number. So what you'll do is, like, in this, what to do is, you will make the use of you can say power system. That is, you will write over here 16 is to power 0, then this for the first one 16 is to power 1, and it will go like this: 16 is to power 2, 4, 16 is to power 3, as the number of digit increases. Okay, and if it goes this side for decimal this side, then you will write 16 is to power minus 1, 16 is to power minus 2, and so on. Okay, if it is right side of the decimal, and if it is left side, then you will see the base and you will write, and you will write the power of that below that particular number. Okay, and for this you can see that there are two numbers, so 16 is to power 0 and 16 is to power 1. So what you do is, to find out the equivalent decimal number, 6 into 16 is to power 0 plus 1 into 16 is to power 1. I hope you are getting it. So it will be 16, right? And it will be your 16 is to power 1, 16 raised to power 2, sorry, it will be 16, and it will be 6, because 16 raised to power 0 is equal to 1, right? So it will be 22. So you can see, and like this, the same way you will do for octal also. Like, for octal you will write 8 over here, okay, and you will just multiply it, you will get the equivalent like this. And if you talk about the binary one, for binary also same way you will do. What you will do is, like, if you have a number like this, for binary you will have numbers like this. Okay, like, let's take this number as 001. Then what you'll do is 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2. Okay, and again you will repeat the same process, but here you can take it as 0, because if you multiply it by 0, it will be 0. So you can directly take this one. So 2 to the power 1 will be 1, so it will be equivalent 1. Okay, so the system is same. So this was the introduction and the counting part of your binary number system. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do subscribing, and thanks for watching.